The iOS 18.3 beta is here, and in this video, we are going to talk about all of the new features that it is going to bring to your iPhones. But before we start, if you are new to this channel, then do not forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notification for future uploads. So here we go. So the very first thing you need to know that it is huge in size. Depending on what iPhone you got, the iOS 18.3 package will vary from 6GB to 8GB as it will replace the whole OS on your smartphone. But that's quite normal because now the iOS packages are coming huge in size, especially because of the Apple intelligence that alone itself occupies more than 3GB on your iPhones. So as you can see here, my device is running on the iOS 18.3 beta. The version is 22D5034E. That is an early version of iOS 18.3 beta. So if you install it on your device, then you might find few things are not working as expected, but let's have a look what we are getting right now on our device. After installing the iOS 18.3 on your iPhone, the very first thing you will notice after the hello screen comes is that your device will ask for the permission to share the analytics of your iPhone with Apple for improvement. By default, Apple does not provide any option to opt out of it, and the option for that is hidden in the settings. So this is what you would like to do as the first thing after installing the iOS 13 on your smartphone if you do not want to share your iPhone analytics with Apple. For that, you have to go to the settings, scroll down, go to the privacy and security, go to the analytics and improvement. And as you can see, by default, share iPhone and watch analytics is turned on. Tap on this to turn it off, and then we are good to go. One bug on iOS 13 right now is that even though I have selected the dark icons, it is not getting implemented on the lock screen. If I go to my lock screen, you can see for these two apps, the flashlight and the camera, the app icons are still in the light shade. They are not darkened as we are currently getting on iOS 18.2. If you got iPhone 16 series smartphone that comes with the new camera control button, you will find that after installing the iOS 18.3 and choosing the dark icons, the camera control icon in the settings will be darkened as well. Currently on iOS 18.2, it is still showing in the blue color. Unlike the rest of the icons, it is not getting darkened. But once you get iOS 18.3 on iPhone 16 series smartphone, this camera control icon in the setting will be darkened as well to provide better and symmetrical visual experience. Another difference I have noticed on my iPhone after installing the iOS 18.3 is in the image playground. The way it is creating pictures on iOS 18.3 is a bit different. For example, this one is running on iOS 18.2. Here I got iOS 18.3. I am using the exact same image on Image Playground, and you can see the differences. The facial structure is a bit different on iOS 18.3 here. The smile is wide and a bit creepy. The partition of the hair is also different. It's mirror image actually. Left is going to right, right is going to left. If we include some themes, then once again, you can see the difference in the images being generated. This is iOS 18.2, this one is iOS 18.3. The hair is, of course, is getting way different compared to what we are getting on 18.2 here. If we use some text prompt, exactly same text prompt, but slight variation in the generation of the images, as we can see here. But since these are AI generated images, we cannot say much how they are being processed. But right now, as you can see, it's looking a bit different on iOS 18.2 and iOS 18.3 for sure, especially when it comes to generation of a human face from the picture. Another change in the iOS 18.3 is that the iPhone 15 wallpapers are gone now from the list of wallpapers. Even on the iPhone 15 Pro I got here, does not come with the iPhone 15 wallpaper. Maybe it's just a bug and Apple will include the iPhone 15 wallpaper in the final release of iOS 18.3, but right now it's nowhere, as you can see. Another thing Apple updated with the iOS 18.3 for iPhones is the Apple Sports application. In the new version 2.3 on iOS 18.3, now Apple Sports includes the new ways to track which teams have qualified for the postseason and which have been eliminated in the league standings section. You can quickly catch up on scoring, plays, and big moments in a game with key plays. A new play-by-play tab is included for that. Now the soccer and baseball game pages will include the pre-game lineup, and you can even schedule a live activity for any game on the Today's tab to automatically get a real-time scorecard on your lock screen when the match starts. The iMovie application is also updated along with the iOS 18.3 that comes with a fix for the issue when setting permission for Photos library was freezing the iMovie application. The iOS 18.3 also comes with some fixes. The primary one is the issue where personalized Genmoji was not getting created without selecting a different person first, and it also fixed the writing tools issue where third-party apps adopting the writing tools API on iOS were getting the issues with the UI view. So this is something developer-oriented issue fix on iOS 18.3. In terms of performance, after iOS 18.3, the performance of the iPhone is increased slightly. I performed the Geekbench 6 benchmark on my iPhone 15 Pro after installing the iOS 18.3, and I got 2965 in single core and 7532 in multi-core. That is slightly better compared to what I was getting earlier. Only 1 point in the single core and around 85 points in multi-core. And in the GPU test, I got 28682. That's nearly 5% improvement in the GPU result, as I was getting 27,300 in the GPU test before installing the iOS 18.3. So you can expect slight performance improvement after installing the iOS 18.3 on your iPhones, especially when it comes to gaming. After the update, the battery performance is looking quite nice. My device is set to be charged only up to 80%, and last night I was playing PUBG Mobile for around 2 hours, and the battery percentage reduced from 80 to 61% only. As you can see, 2 hours 40 minutes, the screen was active since the last charge, and right now it is at 61%. So we can expect that with the iOS 18.3, the battery performance will either improve or it will be pretty solid, as we are getting currently with iOS 18.2 on our iPhone. Another new feature that you will find on iOS 18.3 is the ability to add the robot vacuums in the Home application, as it is confirmed in the source code of iOS Beta 3 developer version. The battery intelligence feature that shows the information that how much time it is remaining to charge the battery up to maximum limit, whether it is set to 80, 90, 95, whatever percentage you have selected, is not yet available on iOS 18.3. It is supposed to show the information how much time it will take in charging the battery fully between these two icons, but as you can see, it is still not yet available after installing the iOS 18.3. Another important thing you need to know and consider if you're planning to install the iOS 18.3 is that it is launched in the second half of December, and as you can see that holidays are starting very soon, so there won't be any further updates to iOS 18.3 for 2-3 weeks at least. And if you find any bug on your device or it is not working perfectly, then you won't be able to get any bug fixes by Apple on your iPhone, and you won't be able to revert back to 18.2 as well. So keep this thing in your mind, and if you got multiple iPhones, then it is better to install the iOS 18.3 on your non-primary device. So this is all about the iOS 18.3 and the new features settings it brings in the beta version. Feel free to share your feedback in the comment section below that what you think about this new update from Apple. And if you enjoyed watching this video, then give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe the channel, and I will see you guys next time in another video. Have a nice day.